Hello everyone. Our today's topic is based on various tools and techniques used for quality planning. And we will also discuss about the various output parameters that are used for quality planning. In my previous video tutorial, I will discuss each and everything that is needed for inputting a quality planning, like quality policy, a brief overview for this, that is quality policy, scope statements, product description, standard and regulations, and other process outputs. So now, today we will discuss about the various tools and techniques that are used for quality planning. And tools and techniques are based on a benefit and cost analysis, benchmarking tools, flowcharting tools, design of experiments. These are the various techniques that are used for quality planning. And in output section, we will discuss about what type of output a quality planning generated, like a quality management plan will be generated. And operational definition will be generated, checklist will be generated, input to the other processes, that is again using a quality planning processes is generated. So let's discuss these all tools and techniques and outputs in detail. See, a first tool and technique for quality planning is that is benefit and cost analysis. A benefit and cost analysis, a name suggests that this type of tools and technique are based on a parameters that are used to evaluate a benefits of the product, a cost of the based of the product, our quality or is based on the benefits of that particular product or that particular software or a cost of a particular software. So we will discuss this. The planning process must consider a benefit and cost trade-off. In this planning process, we will consider a benefit and cost trade-off in detail. And in next, the primary benefit is less work, higher productivity, lower cost, and increased stakeholder satisfaction. If these benefits are covered in our quality planning, so we say that the product quality is good one. And the cost, the what is the primary cost? Is the expenses associated with PQM activity, means product quality management activity. If a cost associated with this type of activity is cost calculated at this stage, and on the basis of these two benefits and a cost base, we can evaluate a techniques for quality planning. In next is that is benchmarking. A benchmarking involves comparing actual or planned project practices to those of the other projects to generate ideas to. Means in this we will generate a benchmarks at a certain level. On the basis of this benchmark, we will evaluate a quality of the planning, quality planning of the software. Like example, generate ideas for improvement. What is to be improvement is needed for this particular software or a product. Provide a standard for measurement of the performance, means a various standards will be provided to measure the quality performance, or we say that the benchmarking performance of our system. Means in this we will check the throughput of the system. Throughput is a various benchmarking strategy with the help of which we calculate the performance on the basis of a particular threshold value. And the other project compared may be within the same organization or outside, may be within the same application area or in another. Means we can evaluate this benchmark on same application also, other applications also, or same application from the other areas also. On the basis of these, we will calculate the benchmarking process. So next, that is our next tool and technique is that is we adopted is like flowchart. It's a common one. A flow charting is a technique where we will design analysis of our quality system is generated. If our system quality is generated with the help of flow chart, we can examine the quality of system on the basis of this flow chart strategy also. What is flow chart? A flow charting technique is a quality management generally includes cause and effect diagrams. Second is system or process flow charts. With a cause and effect diagrams are the flow chart diagrams where we can calculate causes. And after that, we calculate the effect of these causes on our system. And in system and process flowchart is a basic flowchart diagram where we can flow from top to down while following various parameters. And flowcharting can help in anticipating problem quality problem and thus help to develop approaches for dealing with them. Means a various anticipating problems are generated here, a quality problem are generated here. If these are the problem maybe exist in our system. So on the basis of these analysis, we can find a quality of the system. Well, let's discuss these two general include management techniques. First one is cause and effect diagram, and second one is system process flowchart with the help of an examples. See, this is an example of first method that is adopted, that is cause and effect diagram. You can see here The potential causes are in the left side and effect from these are in the right side. Means a time, mature, methods, material, energy, measurement, personals, and in environment. These all are some causes. That is the potential causes we say. On the basis of these causes, a various types of quality management is done. And these causes are combined to form a effect. And that effect is we called a major defect. Our major defect is if these problem maybe exist or this will any of these number of potential causes are increases, so the major defect may also increase. So these are the cause and effect diagram. On the basis of this diagram, we will examine the product strategy based on the cause and effect. And next we will discuss about that is a simple process flow chart. You can see this is a simple process flow chart mechanism. With that, we can adopt or we can use a top-down approach. Here, a project request is done, and next stage is we compile the copy and develop a network. A decision statement is used with the help of diamond symbols. Yes or no is here, stages is here. I mean, this is all about a flow diagram. In this flow diagram, a detailed description of our project is given. In detailed description, like first we do this, and second we do this, and third we do this. After that, there are options. If else statement is here, we can go for this side, we can go for this side. If yes, we go this side, no, it goes to this side, and then move to next step. After our looping is here, we can revert back to our previous state. This all is done with the help of this flowchart. So these techniques, flowcharting technique is best one to predict a quality of the system. On the basis of these flowcharting technique, we can examine the quality. So next we will discuss a tool and technique quality planning, that is a design of experiment. This is again a technique we say about experiment. Experiments are a real-time entity, or we can say the real-time processes that are implemented on a system. By examining the system, we can say that this is the experimentation. So this is an analytical technique which aims to define variables that have most influence on the overall outcome. Means a variable that are various obviously using, or maybe we can say that the defined variable that are most influencing using in this. So we can examine this variable. Is this variable quality product? Is variable is generating any error? If generating any error, we can say that our quality will be degraded. And this technique is commonly applicable to the product of the project issues. So this technique is applicable on the product that is have a project issue. We can identify these issues by experimenting the project. We can experimenting the product development or product description. So this is helpful technique. And next is, however, this technique can also be used in project management issues such as cost and schedule trade-off to allow for optimal solution. Means if any type of trade-off or any type of confusion in the cost and scheduling is available, so this type of technique is adopted for experimenting. We will check that is cost is affected our system, is cost is affected our scheduling of a system. So these are the various parameters. So these are the some basic techniques, or we can say the tools that are used for quality planning, for building a quality product. So now we will discuss about what output to be generated by our quality plan. One more parameter is available, like a cost of quality. Total cost of all the efforts to achieve product service quality, that is cost of performance and cost of conformance. Conformance means a prevention cost or appraisal cost. What cost is needed for a prevent a system from other type of bugs, or a appraisal cost, a hot type of needed for advertisement purpose, for gaining appraisal of the system. This cost is also confirming by this parameter. And the cost of quality is also non-conformance. Non-conformance like internal failure, external failure, these type of failures are can't countable, or we can say that is a failure is never countable, a failure is suddenly generated or suddenly occurred. So this is a cost quality parameter. Now we will discuss about the various outputs that are generated from a quality plan. Outputs from quality planning can be, we can discuss about these in previous, that these are the various quality parameters for output generation. Now we discuss one by one in detail. First is output is that is quality management plan. A quality management plan should describe how a project management team will implement its quality policy. Means managerial plan is here, a management is here. Management will design a policy for our project development. A project management, a team will be implemented. So on the basis of this policy, we can examine our system. So output plan, on the basis of quality plan, we can examine that ki by using this type of quality management system, our system may quality may be improved. We plan first. So also called a quality system. Like ISO, we use a quality system in an integration for International Standard Organization is using here. The plan should be defined already. The organization structure is defined, role of responsibility is defined, resource needed for implementation quality management defined. We in the planning stage, if we have got ISO certification, so all things are already planned. The organization structure is defined in ISO. This structure is used for development. Roles and responsibilities are already, policy is defined here, resource in need of implementation quality management also defined. But this is the main output. And in this also, the quality plan should address a quality control of the project also, a quality assurance also, a quality improvement of the project also. We will discuss these three in detail next PPD or next video tutorial, like quality, what is quality control parameters are, what are quality assurance is here, how this is implemented. So these outputs are generated by this quality plan. Our system is quality assured, we say our quality improvement project is designed, we could, quality control project is done, this is all is done in output process. And next is, that is operational definition. Operational definition is again an output strategy. In this, an operational definition describes what something is and how it is measured by the quality control processes. For example, the project management team must indicate the start and end of every activity's detail schedule. We define that what is our starting activity, what is our ending activity in detail. So operational planning is here. Quality planning is based on operational definition. What is to be operational? And whether the whole activity or certain deliverable are to be measured. So also we define that when we compute our whole activity at one time, what is to be delivered to a customer? What quality product is delivered to a customer? This is already planned. And operation definition also called a metric in some area of application. Or this type of, in exam you say that metrics for quality planning, we can explain operational definition in the same proportion. So next we will discuss a next output parameter, that is checklist. A checklist is a structure tool that is used for verify that a set of required steps or requirement have been performed. Means here we can checklist a set of some number of steps are there. We will checklist that these two structure tools are verified, the set of step requirement that is verified or not, each by one, and on the basis of this the output plan is generated. But if these are checklisted, we can say that our quality planning is good one, or we can output of quality planning is good one. And the many organizations have standard checklists to ensure consistency of frequently performed activities. So these are the major tasks for this. Next is, that is inputs to other processes. A last output that is generated by a quality planning, that is input to other processes. Means we already say about that quality planning can be a newer one, or we can say that in the previously executable product or a project plan, we can also define a project quality plan. So this type of output is generated here. The quality planning process may identify need for further activity in another area. Means another further activities, like if our product is going on, we have to improve the quality of our product. We can use this type of outputs or these outputs for generation of our updating our system to a quality planning system. So these all are the various types of quality plannings, or we can say is the tools and techniques and output generation for quality planning. So we discuss these all in detail today. Now we conclude this PPT. We conclude the steps that is needed for quality planning PPT. First we discuss inputs and tools and techniques and output, all are processed here. You can watch it, or we can, if you have any comment, you can comment me out on my WhatsApp link or WhatsApp number personally, or while commenting this video. Hope so you enjoy it. If any problem, you can discuss with me. Thank you guys. Have a nice day.